your company and in companies of your size, the commitment and the understanding is there that this needs to be the corporate priority now, not next quarter's profits. It is on the top agenda of our discussions. So actually, it is now mandatory that every management team in every single country, DHL Group exists in every country on earth, right? So we basically are the real global multinational. We're everywhere because we have to deliver stuff. Right? Now, the good thing is investors are also on board. I think in the last couple of years, we've seen our investors asking, as a company, what else can you do to reduce carbon footprint? We want to run our aviation fleet to be 60% on sustainable aviation fuel by 2030. The investors are not asking how much are you spending on aviation fuel. They're asking, can you do it faster? Let me just bring in Ole here. Ole, you're a scientist. You don't answer to investors. You don't have a bottom line profit motive. Your agenda is to feed ASEAN and the broader Asian region and perhaps even further by growing rice. What do you think, sitting in an environment like this, talking to business leaders and political leaders and hearing what they have to say? How does a scientist respond to the level of debate that's being held?
Well, I'm generally looking at the whole agricultural sector, no? And then looking at one company, I always think, oh, that's